Hi Gabrielle, I'm Sierra, and today I'm going to be giving you a little bit of feedback on your narrative piece. I thought you did a really nice job, and I have all of the comments on the side so you can read them as well, but I'm just going to go through and kind of explain my thinking as I was giving you the feedback. I like in the beginning how you take your paragraph and you're explaining why you're clumsy and why it makes sense that this event would occur. I think what you can do here is you can put both of those paragraphs, the first two together, and that'll just be your introduction. So you don't need to worry about, as a reader, I guess, it kind of makes you think that you're moving on to share something else when you go into your second paragraph. So if you put it together, I'll know, or the reader will know, that it's all one paragraph and it's giving an introduction, giving background information. So that we can figure out why you broke your ankle. Also, I have never broken a bone. That's a lie. I broke both of my thumbs, but breaking an ankle sounded so painful. And so here I just was talking about how you use similes throughout the whole thing, and it's really cool. Because that helps a reader really be zeroed in on what's going on and kind of be able to picture it in their minds. Here you had, it was as if someone had broken a stick over their knee. Right there, I could picture the sound. I could picture somebody kind of snapping a twig over their leg. What you might want to consider is giving us even more imagery. I am pulling up the model that the videos that have been posted talked about, the climb. If you haven't read it, I suggest you read it. This will give you some ideas. So here, this narrative writer really pulled in some imagery down here at this paragraph, saying the climb ascended steeply above us. Along the right edge, the jungle hugged the rock passage through its trees did not look feasible. The majority of my view was filled with rocks. Looming high to the sky, the boulders rose in a tiered manner. Peering back down toward the river, I saw a steep slope of rocks all the way to the water. All I could think about was how far it would be to fall. So here, it's giving the reader an image of the surroundings. So it's told us through vision, with what's going on in the sky. Instead of just saying that there was a forest, instead it's really expanding and saying the jungle hugged the rocks. So here we can see that the rocks are right up against the forest. Instead of her just saying that, she's painted a picture with her words. And I think you can do that more with your piece as well. So here it gives me, where is it? My ankle collapsed and bent inward, which caused a loud popping noise that was so evident that I wasn't the only one who heard it. So here you use a simile right afterwards. I guess this would be a metaphor. You're using a metaphor right here, and I think you can expand it even more. Really tell us what was it like. Give us some more words and feeling. And I think that will also happen with one of the suggestions that I gave you here. So my glow, which is all of the positive things that I'm loving about your piece, with the structure, you're giving us background information, you're giving us the story of how your ankle actually broke, and then you're going into your, I like that you're using the figurative language because that's giving us more specific sensory details. So then I think in order to help us really have more of those sensory details, I think if you just zoom in on the moment that you break your ankle, so taking out this whole portion where you're telling us about the recovery and really expanding in this section. And a way that you could do that, which will also bring more suspense to the piece as well, would be to almost change the way that you're telling the story. In yours, you're telling the story through the perspective of where you are now. So you're looking back on it and you're saying this happened this way. Instead, consider making it where you're telling the story as your 17-year-old self. So you're telling everything that's happening currently. And another idea that you can use with that, which will make it more emotional for us, will give us more details, is consider using inner dialogue. So you talking to yourself, and you can do that by italicizing your thoughts. So in the climb, they do, my tense thoughts were interrupted by the realization that my friends were already beginning to climb. My anxiety increased as I watched them. So the narrator is saying my anxiety is increasing. And then here, they're giving us an example of giving us their inner thoughts. Do I turn back now? My whole being shouted yes. Will I regret it later? I really want to get to the top, but... And then it continues on to the piece. So putting in a couple of those inner dialogues, or like you could do a whole paragraph on your inner dialogues, especially the moment that right after your ankle breaks, what were you thinking? Were you panicking over trying to find your dad? When your dad's trying to move you, what were you screaming in your head? And one of the things that we can do as narrators is we can kind of elaborate on our inner thoughts and our events. So maybe you don't know exactly what you were thinking at that moment, but try to put yourself back into that position. And as long as it's realistic in your thoughts, then you have literary liberty to do that. So consider doing that, because it'll bring more suspense. It'll really expand and zoom in on this portion of it. Give us more details. So those are just a couple of things. Let me know if you need any other ideas. But I think you have a great story working, and I think you can really pull us in with that, because you've got a pretty crazy event that happened. And I think you can definitely tell your readers more about what it's like. Because for me, I could tell you exactly what it's like to break your thumb during sporting events. Couldn't tell you what it feels like to break an ankle. I can imagine it, and I think you could really pull us in by doing that. So I will talk to you later. I'll see you next week. And thank you so much for helping me out. See ya.